Let's go to beautiful, beautiful Malta. And within Malta, you have an area known as San Gwann. And within San Gwann, there are some cart tracks there. They're also known as the Tal Mensija cart tracks. Now, I went there and the place is fenced off. So I proceeded to film around the fence. And then luckily I met a very friendly, very helpful local guy there who helped me out, and I ended up going to the local council for the keys to actually get into the cart tracks. And just to say that there are some buildings that are on that lot of land, and the local guy was saying that they have been put there illegally. According to him, it's, you know, a bit of local fraud, if you will. But anyway, we will start off at the council building getting the keys. Enjoy. I'm now at the local council and have a key to get into the cart ruts. So with the key and with the help of a local man, very generous with his time, I went to the council, I have the key, and now I can get through this gate apparently and into the area, and that dog is out because evidently it's very protective of the ruts here. Okay, so I'm through the gate. The dog is up above and barking occasionally, and we'll just go through now and have a look at these ruts. These certainly are significant ruts, and they're huge. Just having a good look through here and here. Now here you can see it's like a trench that's been dug through. You can actually see the markings within here. Thank you, sir.
Okay, pal, you got it?
Yeah, thank you so much.
That's very nice.
Thank you. Okay, back to it. Let's follow this along. So they're quite huge here. The ruts are just huge going through here, like so, with a twist. So with the measuring tape here, it's about 40 centimeters in height, at least with the cart rut here. So this is the same spot roughly here. We got around about 40 centimeters at least high, and looking at it again with the tape measure across, getting about 30 centimeters right at the top there, and the total width across is at about the 170 mark. So there's a bit of a drop away here. And let's do a 180 and just have a look at that. Now you can see there's a little bit of a difference in the cart ruts here. There's more of a kind of a wiggle through here. You can just see that one has a different shape to this one. So now, looking this direction, we will keep flowing through. Just a bit of an idea of the scene. 360. Now the ruts go off this direction, and certainly this direction also. Let's follow these ones. Just turning to the side here for a moment. Certainly the main of the ruts are here. Interesting that there, you can see that there is a rut, looks to be, that's very curious in this part. So erosion here. And we'll have a look at this from another direction. So there's that odd part there. So it looks as though there may have been some erosion within what's going on here. So we're still coming away from those houses towards this direction. There are further ruts over this direction. We'll have a look at that right now. So we're now having a look at this. And this is where it just drops. The ground just drops away in this case. Now this would probably lead though to those ruts there. At one stage, or it still kind of does, it matches up. Okay, further down the track, down this path, and taking a look through. Now it gets crazy here with really deep ruts, and certainly erosion can play a part, certainly, but nonetheless, through we go, and it really dives down, and it's filled up with debris, as we can see down here with these ruts. More coming across this way. And it's absolutely filled with grass and soil. And we get to the edge of the area here. So just another bit of a look back through this area. So it goes right up. And of course it goes alongside the house here, the houses. Now on the island of Gozo, you have the little ribs in the ground in the area of the cart ruts. And I keep saying cart ruts, but as we call them. Now here in San Juan, you have the cart ruts, and I've just noticed that also this ribbing is in the ground also, and can be seen, or the remnants of it, going through here. So the houses are just up here for reference once again, and those little sort of ribs are right in about here. And so there are various markings here, and even though it's a possibility that they go up through this way as well, sort of over the chaotic chaotic ruts here. Very unsure about this. It's just a remote possibility, very remote possibility in my mind. Okay, for accuracy, this looks to be natural to me. There's a natural run through the rock, and it continues over this way. with this part here. Huge dip here. So this is part of the situation here. It definitely looks different to the rut situation, but nonetheless. And then the other aspect is the erosive quality. It's like there's a sort of a paternal-like quality to the rock. Once that breaks through, the rock really erodes away. There are many calls as to what is going on, but I certainly find it fascinating. I'm not drawing any conclusions here, just basically documenting what is here at San Gwann.
This is where you were, San Gwann.
Yeah. As it turns out, these houses, this development was going on kind of over the ruts here, the ancient ruts, so they have stopped development. Evidently this was not supposed to happen here, according to the local man.